I want to read for you a certain part in Rashi. Rashi on that Retzi'ah, on that last part, is saying, Uma ra'a ozen lehiratzea, and why the ear is the part that HaKadosh Baruch Hu chose to make a hole in that ear. Mikol sh'ar evarim shebaguf, from all of the rest of the organs in the person's body. Amar Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai, so Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai said, ozen zot, that ear, ששמעה על הר סיני, that she heard on Mount Sinai, לא תגנוב, that you're not allowed to steal, והלך וגנב, and now that person went and steal, תירצה. So we're going to make a hole in that ear because she heard the הלכות and she broke the הלכות. Which הלכות she broke? The fact that a person become to be a slave, it's because he owe a certain amount to the owners, and now he actually cannot pay, so he's selling himself. The reason that the persons have lackings, it's because of their crimes, sins, bad things that they've done. Any surim below avon. The person is not suffering if he didn't do something that created it. Ve'im mocher atzmo, and if that person is selling himself, so why we gonna punish him? If it's not because he stolen, just he want to gain money. Person want to work as a slave, and he gonna get salary from for that. He want to get food. He gonna get dorms. It's good for him to be a slave. It's better for him. He can choose that. So, ozen. So why he gonna get punished at his ear? Because ozen sheshama al har Sinai, a ear that heard on Mount Sinai, ki li bnei Israel avadim. Am Israel gonna be my slaves. Hakadosh Baruch Hu said to all of Am Israel. Halach vekana adon leatzmo. You went and you bought to yourself another master instead of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Now you have two masters. Like we learned in Masechet Chagiga, that a slave, he cannot go to Beit HaMikdash to sacrifice Korban Re'ya and Korban Chagiga. Why? Because he doesn't have only one master. Person have to have only one master, only Hashem Yitbarach. So because he heard that his master is only HaKadosh Baruch Hu, and he decide to choose to himself another master, so his ear gonna be injured. So actually every person with his desires and with faith that it's not only in Hashem Yitbarach, means that he believes in other things, so actually he's creating to himself other masters. Now he bought to himself a car, so now there is problems with the car, so he become to be a slave of his car. He have to take care of that car, to take it to the garage, to put fuel every few kilometers, and he become to be a slave of his car. A person took on himself desires for food, desires for sleep, so he become obligated to those masters that they are controlling his life.
A dog.
All of the time.
A pet.
So.
Pet. My wife.
Pet. Also. So. Actually, what's gonna be with a person like that, that he become to be a slave of the rest of the desires? We heard that his ear gonna be injured. So what the ear is reflecting to us? What is it come to teach us? So, oznaim, the ears, it's actually the thing, the organ that we gonna hear with it. So what we supposed to hear? Torah shebe'al peh, divrei chachamim. Torah shebichtav, we can see with our eyes. But divrei chachamim, we should listen to them. We should use our ears to hear them. So when a person has got problems with his ears, It means that he is not listening to the voice of Chachamim. אין לו אמונת חכמים. He don't believe, he does not believe in the Chachamim. So if a person is selling himself to be a slave of the desires, chas v'shalom, of all of his nonsense, so the result going to be that he will not believe in Chachamim, in the diburim of Rabotenu, of rabbis, of the tzaddikim, that in the generation, like he should. So actually, each and every one of us have to look deep inside how actually we should serve Hashem Yitbarach. Because like we learned in Likutei Moharan, in the Torah that we're learning now, in Torah Yud Zayin, that a person cannot get closer to Hashem Yitbarach, cannot reach Yira and Ahava, fear from Hashem Yitbarach, and love to Hashem Yitbarach, unless he is close to Tzadikim. Now, I was, a few moments ago, I was sitting outside with a person that came from the United States for a visit. And he asked me, do you know what is the worst day that people that are coming to Eretz Israel, what is their worst day when they're coming to Eretz Israel? When people are coming to Eretz Israel, not to live, to a visit, what's going to be the worst day for them when they're going to come to visit
the day they leave
the country,
the day they arrive?
So I told him that for sure it's the day that they're supposed to go back to the United States, the day they're supposed to leave Eretz Israel. So he said, you're right. Every time that you're leaving Eretz Israel, you feel like you're doing something that actually you cannot do. Actually, you cannot leave Eretz Israel, but you're forced to do it, and you're doing it. So I asked him, so why are you doing it? If you feel that you have to stay here, if you feel that your house is here, so why are you going? So he said, this is how Hashem wants. And I felt that I cannot argue with him, and that I cannot start talking to him about free will and about the free choice that the person has in his life. So I told him, all right, Bezrat Hashem, you're going to come one day. But actually you see from that the person, he become to be like a slave. He doesn't have a free choice. He feels, I'm not talking about that person, I'm talking about myself. A person that he's got desires, a person that he's got cables that are dragging him to something. What you got there? You got a house, you have a car, you have people, you have, what you have? You have things that you desire to be with those things. You attach to those things. But then, you become to be like that you have a different master. Like that you cannot decide yourself what to do with your life, like a slave. That he doesn't have a free choice in his life. If he want to continue do that job, that work, he cannot release himself. He have to wait until his master is going to release him after 6 years. So a person that he is in that prison of desires, he cannot set himself free. So this is why HaKadosh Baruch Hu is so... You can see that HaKadosh Baruch Hu is angry at that person that he is selling himself to be a slave. He is punishing him. And this is the suffering, all of our suffering, all of the bad feelings that we have, it's a result of the fact that we don't have faith in Hashem Yitbarach. This is why we're suffering. That slave, why he sold himself to be a slave? He saw himself to be a slave because he could not believe that HaKadosh Baruch Hu going to provide him the things that he need. He didn't have faith in the beginning that HaKadosh Baruch Hu told him in Mount Sinai that he's not allowed to steal, and that HaKadosh Baruch Hu going to give him everything and he doesn't need to go to steal for that. He did not believe in that, so he chose with his free choice to drop faith and to grab the money and to run after the money. And the result became that he saw himself to be a slave. And if he sold himself to be a slave, now the result going to be that he cannot break his chains anymore. Why? Why he cannot break his chains? Because he lost emunat chachamim. Because he cannot believe in chachamim. Like in Siyata Dishmaya, today we learned in the Gemara Kedosha, that ish chacham yechaperena. Only if you're going to a Rebbe, if you're going to a tzaddik, the tzaddik can break your vow. He can break your neder. If a person took something on himself, and now he have to break it, he should go to a Rebbe. He should go to a tzaddik. And if you go to a tzaddik, it means that you believe in the tzaddik. You count on the tzaddik. By that power that you count on a tzaddik, that you believe in the tzaddik, by that power the tzaddik can release you from your obligations. The tzaddik, he's got the power to break those chains of avdut, slavery. He can break you from those chains, and he can bring you back to the level of a free person, individual. You're allowed to do whatever you believe that is the right thing. He can put the powers to be yourself, to go back to be who that you really are. We can see also something very important about that path of being yourself. Because to be yourself, actually to rely on the power of the tzaddikim, that they are telling you to believe in yourself and to go and to do good things for the general public and for other people and for yourself, to believe in yourself, to know that you can serve Hashem Yitzvarach yourself, even that you feel that you're weak, even if you don't believe in yourself, the tzaddikim are encouraging you, they're telling you good things, to go, to believe in yourself, to go, to do things that it looks like huge things. How are you going to do that? This is the right question. Because if now, after they gave you the power to believe in yourself and to go to serve Hashem, if now you're going to forget them, now if you're going to believe in your individual's powers, you're going to fall into a deeper mistake than you were in the beginning. Because kol ha-gadol mi-chavero yitzro gadol mi-meno. Everyone that he become bigger, so his Yetzirah is growing with him. When a person is killing his Yetzirah on a certain level, let's say a person now he is in a certain level. In that level, now he's got certain power and he's got a certain Yetzirah that is fighting against him. But now, if he's having a Yirur HaTshuva, he wants to fix himself, he's not happy with his level, he wants to do bigger things, so he regrets on his bad actions, on his sins. If now, with those, if he now he's going to do Tshuva in that low level, the result going to be that he's killing his Yetzirah. The Yirur HaTshuva are killing the Yetzirah. Remove the Yetzirah from him totally. What's going to be the result now? He is free from those last cables that he had to stay in that level, and he's climbing to the next level. What's going to be in the next level? He's going to meet the older brother of that last Yetzirah that he killed. And that older brother, he's angry now, and he's stronger now, and he wants to win now. So what you have to do now? You have to fix yourself also in that level. But how did you climb from the last level to that level? By the tzaddik, like we said. You cannot get Yirat Shamayim and love to Hashem Yitbarach unless you're close to the tzaddik. Unless you're listening to the voice of the tzaddikim that are telling you that you can do things, that you should believe in yourself, that you're going to succeed, that, like Rabbeinu said, Malachem Lidog, you don't need to be worried about anything. Simchu Al Kochi. You should count on my power, on the power of an old person that he is inside Kedusha. Rabbeinu said all of those things. The tzaddikim are encouraging us to continue to do amazing things, to believe in ourselves. So, the fact that you climbed, it was because that you believed in the tzaddik. That the tzaddik broke those chains and let you climb and let you gave you the option to progress, to continue to climb in your life. So now you got to a new level. You have to understand that you cannot succeed yourself. You have to count on the tzaddik also here. A person is starting his tshuva, he understands that HaKadosh Baruch Hu made miracles with him, he woke him up in the middle of the darkness and sent him to do tshuva, and now he knows that it's Hashem. Now he is inside the yeshiva, he's already learning Torah, and now he forgets Hashem. Now he's thinking all of the time where he's going to find his parnasa from, and how he's going to do tshuva, how he's going to learn better. You're not the one that is bringing your soul back to its source. You're not the one that made tshuva for yourself. HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he was the one that saves you. The tzaddik, he was the one that gave you the smallest advice that you needed then to bring you to those small levels that you climbed in the beginning. And now when you need bigger advice, bigger information from higher, for your higher level that you're holding in now, you have to have the tzaddik with you. Now you have more responsibility on your shoulders. Now you can see your lackings in a lot of in a very clear,
more clearly.
So you have to have an advice from a person that was there, because en chacham kebal nisayon. The wisdom is only in the hands of a person that he's got his experience. So you have to lie and to lean on a tzaddik. So now in your tshuva, you have to understand that you should go to the tzaddik again and again and again. And you cannot start imagine to yourself that you are the tzaddik now, that you are the one that's going to do tshuva now, you are the one that's going to learn Torah now. No, you have to remember the days that you were in darkness, the days that the tzaddik was taking you from darkness and bringing you now into the light. You have to understand that now, the darkness that you have now in your level, even though that you are in light, you're still in darkness. This light is darkness of the next level. And over there, when you're going to reach that, you also, in the beginning, you're going to feel that you're in the light. But after a while, you're going to see that you're in darkness from the light of the next level. So always we need to have the tzaddik. And in the same Parashat Shavua, as this week, in the Zohar HaKadosh, in Parashat Mishpatim, there is a wonderful thing that we should read, Bezrat Hashem. So, the story here in Parashat Mishpatim, there is a very big part that it calls Ma'amar HaSaba, Saba Mishpatim. And HaSaba, he was... HaSaba... He was, Saba means old person. He was huge and old and very wise tzaddik that came to the students of Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai to explain to them the secrets that behind Parashat HaShavua, our parasha. And he explained to them actually that it's Sod HaGilgulim. In that parasha there is the secrets of, how you say Gilgulim?
Reincarnations.
Wonderful. Reincarnations. So, he's telling them that when a person is a slave, he's in one Gilgul, he's in one lifetime. And when he's selling or coming, so there is a lot of details here, how the person is the soul, and he's selling himself, so he's going into this world, and going back when he's free to the world to come, to heaven. And there is a lot of explanations how he reveals that all of the secrets of reincarnations are written here in that Parashat HaShavua, Parashat Mishpatim. Alright? But now, when he explained those secrets, it's huge secrets. In the Parasha, in the Zohar HaKadosh, Bezrat Hashem, everyone gonna read that parasha, gonna understand that parasha. We can see that he is revealing, that Saba, he is revealing huge secrets to the students of Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai. And they also amazed from all of his chidushim, and they're saying to him that it was worthy to come to this world just to hear those chidushim that he is revealing to them. But after that, he is getting inside into those deep, deep explanations, deep, deep Torah water, very deep water of the Torah. Look what he is saying. It's amazing, amazing thing. And he's saying to himself, Saba, Saba, he's saying to himself, Zaken, Zaken, an old person, how you say Zaken, old person, okay. old man, Masita, what have you done? What have you done to yourself that you put yourself into those deep water? Shtika haita tova lecha. To be silenced, it was better for you. Why did you start talking? We're talking now in the beginning of the parasha. He was talking pages and pages after that he said that it was better to be silent. Hare amarti, I said it, he's saying to himself, שנכנסת בים הגדול בלי חבלים ובלי דגל. You went inside to the big sea, to the huge sea, without a rope and without a flag. You're now inside of a storm, inside of the waves, inside of the in the middle of the sea. You don't have you cannot wave no one to save you. You don't have a rope to pull yourself back to the shore. מה תעשה? What you gonna do? אם תאמר שתעלה למעלה, if you want to say that you're gonna climb up, you're gonna go back, לא תוכל, you cannot, it's too far distance. He means that he's gonna have to explain more of the secrets. Now he can stop in the middle of the parasha. After a few verses that he explained, now he can stop revealing those secrets that he's revealing. He have to continue. אם תאמר שתרד למטה, if you want to say that now you're going to have to go down deep into those secrets, הרי העומק של תהום גדול, the size of the depths, the height of the depths, it's huge. How are you going to go so deep? How are you going to go so far? מה תעשה? What are you going to do? This is us. In your תשובה, you started your תשובה. You went inside your תשובה. What are you going to do now? To go back? You cannot. It's too hard to go back. You don't have where to go back. You have to continue. How are you going to pass all of that path that you have to continue? It's even deeper. It's even larger than to go back. What are you going to do? How are you going to deal with your life of tshuva? You have to face the truth. You have to face things. You have to deal now. What are you going to do? מה תעשה? Hey, Saba. Hey, Saba. He's saying to himself, old man. לא יש לך לחזור לאחור. You cannot go back. No way. This for sure. To go back, it's not an option. בזמנים כאלה לא היית. In situations like those, you were not, and you were not used to, ולא התרגלת להתחלש בתוקפך. To fall down in your powers. It's time to get stronger. Now it's not the time to say, I don't know what to do, I don't have a hope. I remember that a few weeks ago, I went to Rav Shalom, to his house, to ask him a question about a person that his wife went out from the apartment, from their house, with 4 children.
Wow.
Like that, just like that. And I told him, Rav, I tried to talk to that person, to tell him to make ishtadlut, of itbodeduyot, to daven, to go to the fields, hours, 6 hours, something to try to convince Hashem to break that horrible decree, to do something. And that guy told me that he is despair, that he doesn't have the power to do that, and he is not capable because of all of his sorrow. So when I said that to Rav Shalom, Rav Shalom told me, now it's the time for despair. Now he should put all of his effort. When everything gonna be wonderful, everything gonna succeed, then he can be despair. Then he can rest. Now is the time to rest. Now, so now, you're in the middle of the war. You feel that the waters are coming on your head from all sides. There's no hope for you. You're drowning. This is the time to give up. This is the time to put your effort. This is the time that you should suffer for Hashem Yitbarach.
איפה הוא עכשיו? יש טוב?
בעזרת השם יהיה טוב.
אוקיי.
So, כי ידעת, and he's telling to himself, that old, huge, tzaddik, old man, כי ידעת שכל אדם אחר, any other person, בכל דור הזה, in that generation, you know that he's telling to himself, לא נכנס באונייה בעמקות הזה שאתה שמה. No one in that generation, even with a ship, with a boat, he's not getting inside to those depths that you went inside without a flag and without a rope. So for sure that you have to be strong now, even the strong people. And that also, like Rav Shalom said yesterday in the end of Likutei Moharan, the last Torah in Likutei Moharan, Rabbeinu Rabbi Nachman explains over there how you should say Tehillim. When you're reading Tehillim, the main thoughts that you, the meaning that you have while you're reading Tehillim, supposed to be that you're reading those Tehillim on yourself. When the Tehillim are saying, when David HaMelech is saying, save me from my enemies, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, so you should mean those verses that you're saying on your Yetzer Hara, that you're davening, that you're asking from HaKadosh Baruch Hu to save you from your enemies, that you have Yetzer Hara that is surrounding you. So the person asked him, and now I'm going to learn the verses that David HaMelech is saying on himself. He asked Rabbeinu Rabbi Nachman, the person asked Rabbi Nachman, how I'm going to explain to myself the verses that David HaMelech said on himself, Ki chassid ani, that he is a chassid, I'm not a chassid. So Rav Shalom said, Rav Shalom explained that Rabbeinu Rabbi Nachman said that a person should look inside to his good points. There is a way to say that you are a chassid, that you have a mesirut nefesh for Hashem Yitbarach. You're right, you're not David HaMelech, but you have a point of David HaMelech, you have a part of David HaMelech inside your soul. Zot Torah Adam, all of the parts of the Torah, HaKdoshah, are inside you right now. So there is a side to say that you are a chassid. Like here we're going to see about the Saba. There is ways to say that you are inside the depths and situations that no one else in this generation can suffer. No one is going even with a boat. Even that he's got money is not going into the dangers that you put yourself in when you're broke, when you don't have money. Even people with wisdom, with connections, with wisdom, I don't know what, they're not putting themselves in situations that you are. So what you should do with yourself, you should find strength. So, and he's saying to himself, Bere de Yochai Yada, even Bere de Yochai, the son of Yochai, it's Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, he knew, Beno Shel Yochai, he knew, look, he's lying, he's leaning on the tzaddik. That Saba, even though that he's huge, even though, like we said before, that you are now inside the tshuva, that you are making hitvodedu, that you are learning Torah Kedosha, even though you should have to count on the tzaddik, you should remember that the tzaddik is bigger than you, that he is the only one that you can rely on. And he's saying like that, the Bered Yochai, Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, Yodea Lishmor Drachav. He knows how to watch his path, how to get inside to the depths. Vim Nichnas Beyam Amok, and when that he is getting inside those depths, the deep, deep water, Mashgiach Mitchila, he is looking before, Miterem Shenichnas, before he is getting inside. He explained to himself that Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai is bigger than him. Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai would not put himself in that situation, hard, awkward situation that he is in now, that he's in the depths and he doesn't know how to deal with those depths. It's climbing on his head. But he remembered by the force of Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai that he knows how to solve all of those problems, how to get out from a very, very deep situations, deep sea. When he is getting inside, and if he is getting inside to the depths, to a big, deep place, Mashgiach mitchila, he is looking from the beginning. Miterem shenichnas, before he enters. Ech yavor befa'am achat. How he gonna finish all of the distance in one time? You are swimming and stopping, swimming and stopping, swimming and stopping. But the tzaddik, he is doing something from the beginning till the end, in one breath. He's not getting into the problems that you're getting inside. So the tzaddik is bigger than you. He's remembering it. Ata zaken, vishotet bayam, and he can go into the depths in the sea. Ata zaken, and you old, לא הסתכלת בתחילה. You did not look from the beginning. You caused problems to yourself in your תשובה, in the path of תשובה. אתה זקן, כיוון שאתה שם, but now, even though that you are there, even though that you have problems from here until the end of the sea, לא תחלש בתוקפך. Don't give up. Be strong. לא תעזוב בכל דרכך לשוטט לימין ולשמאל. Don't look around. Don't wander with your thoughts to the right, to the end. Continue. Go straight. לאורך ולרוחב. Don't go back and forth. Just לעומק ולרום, to the depths, to the heights. אל תירא. Don't be afraid. זקן זקן. התחזק בגבורתך. Be strong with your powers. כמה גיבורים חזקים שברת בגבורתם. How many tests you won already in your life? How many tests HaKadosh Baruch Hu test you and you succeed already in your tshuva? Look at that. Look at your success. Look at the good things that you done. Don't be afraid from the next test that you're going to see in the future and to say, how I'm going to deal with that. Remember the winnings that you have in your past, in your history. How many times you succeed in your life to do wonderful things? How many times? Lie on that. Remember your success. Remember that you have a tzaddik in this generation that he's helping you, that he can do it all in one breath, that he doesn't have no power to deal with the small situations that for you they're huge. You should remember him. You should remember your good points, your success, and to go with that and to conquer the next level, the next stage that you have to achieve. Remember, כמה גיבורים חזקים שברת בגבורתם. Heroes that were standing and fighting against you, you're winning them. You found powers inside your soul to win and to conquer horrible wars. I remember myself, a few years ago, I had a situation here in the yeshiva that I did not do what I'm going to do with myself. I was sure that I'm collapsing, that there is no hope. And I told my wife, the only chance that I'm going to survive in the yeshiva is if I'm going to take my head down and I'm going to come every day to the yeshiva. I will not talk to no one, just put my mind, my eyes inside the books. I'm going to hold my seder. And when I was coming to the yeshiva like that, even though that I had my troubles and I came to the yeshiva, I had so many bad thoughts, so many problems inside my mind, and I told myself, with time, it's gonna pass. It's the only way to deal with problems is to be stubborn against them, not to fight with them, to understand that it's all by the supervision of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Now you need to suffer. Accept it. Put your mind in your limud. Now you have to stand in a certain test. Accept it. Understand it. This is the way that you're going to deal. Remember the days that you succeed. Remember the still HaKadosh Baruch Hu supplied to you now the things that you need, that you should have. And He is helping you. And the Tzaddik is with you. Tzaddik that He is huge with His powers. That He can do whatever you see that you're stopping, that you cannot make. The Tzaddik is so huge, He's so holy. He can do those things easily with one breath. He finish all of the things that are taking to you years on years. He finished them in a moment. He finished those problems in a day, in 2 days, in a week. It was easy for Him because He is huge. He is totally strong. And you should count on His powers. And you should count on the goodness, goodness and the greatness of HaKadosh Baruch Hu that He helped you until now. You're saying to yourself, what am I going to do with the future? The future is exactly like the past. The past, He was also a future once. Before, He was your future. And then now He become to be your past. But actually now your future also going to be your past one day. If you're just going to continue focusing in the future, in the now, in doing right things, into doing your job, everything going to be in your past. You're going to continue that progress of success until the end. You just need to go and continue believing Hashem, to count in the tzaddikim. This is the only way that you can win. וכמה מלחמות ניצחת? How many wars you won? This is it. Thank you very much.